I've been wanting to make this video for a while now because there's something about Disney animated cartoons that I don't think many people realise. And that's that if we take a look at these images here, you can clearly see a steady progression of image quality, animation, realism. Now that's very obvious, but what's not so obvious is how far the hair has come throughout the years. And it kind of blows my mind because just the hair alone has its own world of problems that they had to overcome. For example, as Mr. Green's going to demonstrate here, back in the day, they used to draw directly over a live-action performance, or just use the performance as a reference. And that's all very well and good, up until the point where you start to draw over the hair and realise that drawing thousands of strands each frame is going to take a very long time. Too long. But not to worry, because fortunately there was a very simple solution, which was just that. Keeping it simple. For example, as we can see here in this clip of Snow White, the actress and Snow White herself had their hair up and fixed with a bow. This allowed the hair to be drawn as if it were one solid mass. This continued to be the solution right up until The Little Mermaid, when computers were first used to ink and paint the animators' drawings, like for example here in this farewell rainbow scene. But still, Disney's hair continued to look flat and simplistic, and this still wasn't really a bad thing because the characters themselves and the world they inhabited were also flat and simplistic. However, as technology advanced and characters began to have more detail, hair once again became a problem. And sticking flat and simplistic hair onto a more detailed character, as you can see here, doesn't quite look right. And so Disney's hair needed to evolve. Now, with films like Chicken Little and Bolt, this evolution became noticeable, but it became even more noticeable with Tangled. In fact, you could say that Tangled brought a breath of fresh hair, but not without its own set of problems. For example, if the average human head of hair is composed of over 100,000 individual strands, and not only do these strands interact with the movements of the owner, but they also interact with each other and with external elements such as gravity, humidity, static electricity, or the wind. And as we mentioned before, if hand animating each strand of hair would be an excruciating, if not impossible, task, then how the heck did they make Rapunzel's hair in the movie Tangled look so good? Well, fortunately, with more advanced computer technology available, software engineers could now create software capable of handling such a task. Like, for example, a hair simulation program which they called Dynamic Wires that allowed them to apply the laws of physics to their hair simulation. However, unfortunately, as with many solutions, these also created a new set of problems. You see, if Rapunzel's 20-meter-long locks obeyed the laws of physics, then they would weigh over 30 kilos and would be dragging along the floor and pulling her back. So, in order to allow Rapunzel to move around freely whilst her locks flowed beautifully behind her, the software had to actually allow the animators to adjust the laws of physics too. And in addition to acting in a plausible manner, Rapunzel's hair also had to look good and be directable. So, to accomplish this, the engineers also created iGroup. This tool let animators separate Rapunzel's 140,000 hairs into 174 different tubes. And by doing this, the animators could sculpt the main locks of hair and therefore control the way the hair broke apart and came back together. The next step in Disney's hair evolution was in the film Brave. Meridas Hair wasn't thin and wavy like Rapunzel's, it was wild and curly. Therefore, the software engineers had to evolve their simulation tool. After studying its behaviour, they found that curly hair actually acted a lot like a spring. However, after testing, they found that stiffer springs would hold the shape of the curl but wouldn't bounce like natural hair curls, and looser springs would bounce like natural hair curls, the shape of the curl would unwind and lose its shape. So, to maintain the motion of the hair and the structure of the curl, they added invisible core springs to Meridas' curls to preserve their shape. But these new tools still wouldn't be enough for the next step up the ladder. In Frozen, animators had to control Elsa and Anna's plaits and braids, getting them to move convincingly and stop the separate locks from crashing into each other and doing all sorts of crazy things like suddenly passing through their shoulders. The character's hair also had to interact with the environment, as snow landed on it and the wind blew it, so engineers built a new tool evolving from iGroom called Tonic. This tool is a volume-based tool that allows artists to group hairs into different sections and then shape and direct those sections however they want. Moana was the next step, and in this movie, Disney started to play with hair types. Now, there are actually 12 major hair types. There's straight hair, 1A, 1B, and 1C, wavy hair, 2A, 2B, 2C, curly hair, 3A, 3B, 3C, and coily hair, 4A, 4B, and 4C. Before Moana, Disney had only really simulated type 1B for Rapunzel, type 3B for Merida, and 1B again for Elsa and Anna. But in Moana, they had to simulate type 2B, 1C, 2A, 3C, and 3A. Disney engineers created something they call an elastic rod model. This allowed them to adjust how the wavy hair would retain its spring and twists. The filmmakers wanted Moana to play around with her hair the way young girls do, and because Moana was almost outside, her hair would also be affected by different types of wind. This meant that they had to design a new method of stimulating hair that provided a higher level of artistic control. Hair control allowed artists to set up a number of guide hairs to basically guide the simulated hairs. The more guided hairs they added, the greater the control they had over the simulation, and they could also adjust the amount of variance to control the overall shape. Now, Frozen 2 forced Disney engineers to take yet another step up the evolutionary ladder. This was because Elsa and Anna's hair wasn't separate tight coils like Moana's, but thin and separate strands. This meant they needed to simulate even more hairs per frame, and at an even faster rate than they could do before. So they created a new software to handle such an enormous task, which they justifiably called Beast. Now, Disney could pretty much simulate any type of hair in any type of environment, which was pretty lucky because in 2021 the film Encanto came out and pretty much had them all. But not only did it have every single major hair type, but it also had plaits, braids, hair tied up, short hair, long hair, and Brunos.
Don't talk about Bruno.
Encanto was indeed the culmination of everything Disney has learned to date. The incredible amount of work and ingenuity that Disney artists and engineers put into every Disney film ensures that even though we now have realistic 3D characters in a detailed 3D world that seems light years away from Snow White and Cinderella, they'd still somehow retain that Disney magic.
What are you doing?
Please give us a like if you enjoyed this video. Don't forget the links to the music used in this video are in the video description. And let us know what you thought of this new format. You like seeing more Mr. Green? Let us know in the comments below. Support Mr. Green by sending us a super thanks. Just click on the thanks button under the video and choose an amount to donate. This will ensure Mr. Green gets a new banana. He will be happy. Also, we really appreciate every last one of you guys, so stay safe and thanks for watching our video.